Never had any children of his own. He is filled with paternal instincts. This unexpected side of his character first showed itself when he adopted his three young nephews. And from that moment on, he worked nobly, making one sacrifice after another to bring them up in the great tradition of the American family.
Donald could take it. He also knew how to dish it out. And on his nephew's birthday, he decided to show Huey, Dewey, and Louie a really good time.
Surprise, boys! We're gonna see some of my pictures!
Oh, no!
Mickey Mouse, how'd that get in here? We want to see Mickey Mouse. No, definitely not.
Oh, all right.
Give me that, Mickey Mouse. Okay, watch.
Unlike Mickey, Donald didn't have his own TV show, and he never let anyone forget it.
Oh, come on, Uncle Donald, be a good sport.
I grew up on Mickey Mouse and Donald Duck. In fact, the Mickey Mouse Club was my favorite television show. I'd come home straight from school and I'd turn it on before I'd close the front door. I've got to admit, I was always rooting for Donald. He was bad, and I loved him for it.
Who's the leader of the club that's made for you and me?
M-I-C-K-E-Y-M-O-U-T.
Forever let us hold our banner high.
Take two. Take three. Take 14. We visited the renowned artist Andy Warhol at his studio in New York, where he's working on a new painting celebrating Donald's golden anniversary.
The brilliance of Walt Disney and his team of animators was to take a creature as ordinary as a duck and make him so human. Although Walt just wanted to create a long-lasting character, he succeeded so well. Donald has become not only an institution, but a work of art.
Animation is a 20th century art form. 24 paintings are needed for every second of screen time. Sound is also critical, as Walt Disney explains.
Sound helps to give the character plausibility in two ways. First, by giving him an appropriate voice.
Oh, that's very, very cool.
Second, we must have convincing sound effects. And now, Donald, would you mind helping with a demonstration?
Oh, sure. I'd be glad to. What do I do?
Take off your hat and face the audience. Now you take a real heavy object, say something weighing 3 or 4 tons. This can produce some very plausible effects, both audible and visual. First, the sound, which was made by letting a steel tank drop 10 feet onto the concrete floor of an empty swimming pool with reverberation added. And now let's observe the pictorial result of our experiment.
That's really only half the story. Actually, it's more complicated than that.
I'm here at the
Disney Studios Animation Department to try and unravel the mystery of how Donald Duck comes to life. Why can't I see something happen? You know, all the ducks look exactly the same.
Oh, no, each one is different. See this one? The foot's off the ground. Now we take one picture. This next one, the foot's down. You see?
Well, I get the idea, but I still, Donald hasn't moved.
Just a minute, Dunder.
That's great.
I'll show you. Now look, first, my foot is up here. See?
Uh-huh.
Then, it's down here. Understand?
Now I get it.
Then this?
Yeah.
And this?
I see.
And that? See?
Yeah. Gotcha.
When I'm going faster, I'm working. Get it?
Now I get it.
Now in this picture, I'm a farmer, see? I'm going out to milk a cow. Oh, MacDonald had a farm. How am I doing? Oh, MacDonald had a farm.
Now if he could just afford...